In a previous video, I talked about the difference between Kajabi website and landing pages and why I prefer to use landing pages whenever possible. To make this process though a lot easier, we're going to create a template landing page. So this means one landing page that has your brand logo, fonts, colors, favicon, and your header and footer navigation, your social media links. It has everything customized to you. So in the future, every time you need to create a new landing page, you can just duplicate your template landing page and everything is going to look the same. You don't have to worry about finding your hex codes or your social media links. Everything will be the same and your pages will look really cohesive.
So to create your page, we'll go to website, pages, landing, and then new landing page. And we'll just start with a blank one, because it's going to be pretty much blank anyway. And we'll name it landing page, create. So the first thing we're going to do is customize page settings. And you'll see here we have these two different tabs, sections and settings. So settings, and you want to upload your favicon, which we created already. And you'll notice that it looks super grainy right here because it's such a tiny image, but that's fine. Don't worry about that because it looks fine up in the when it's actually installed. Okay. And style guide, here is where you can change the colors and the fonts. Rather than this Kajabi blue, you would want to change it to one of your brand colors. And you can select it either from here, or you can type in a hex code here, or move it around the color wheel here. You can adjust the transparency. You've got all sorts of options. So let's do that one. And then button background color. Again, this is going to be one of your brightest brand colors or your brightest brand color. Avoid red though. That's just instinctively tells people stop. So you don't want that for like a sales button. So those are your colors and then your fonts. Right here, this is your heading font, which is this Fiera Sans. If we click in here, any of these heading 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is going to be that same font, Fiera Sans, just smaller versions of it. And then this is your body font. So your body font, if you want to see what's going to display there, well, you can highlight that format and then blocks, paragraph. That's what your body font is. I don't know why they can't just call it body font, but. So again, going back to settings, like if you want to update your body font, let's say instead of Open Sans, we want to do this Upreal Fat Face and then save it. It'll update right away. So you'll be able to see what these fonts look like on the page. And Kajabi doesn't have every single font option in the world, but it has a lot. So just find one, especially for your body font, find one that's easy to read. Like that Abriel Fat Face is not a great one. Really the name of the game is just clarity here. And there are some other things that you can change the font colors. I wouldn't really mess it, or the font sizes. I probably wouldn't change any of those other ones. And you can skip these design tools and custom code. I don't really use those. So that's settings, and then your page sections. So we're going to click over to this tab, and there are certain page sections that appear on every page, and you can't delete them. So header is one of them. Also footer, exit pop-up, and two-step opt-in. So those are universal. They are going to be on every page. Now, just because they're there doesn't mean that you have to use them or display them. And you can tell the difference between these pages that you cannot delete or rename. And that's different from these page sections that you, if you hover, you'll see these three dots and you can rename or delete or hide or duplicate these page sections. That's not an option for these other ones. However, like I said, that doesn't necessarily mean that it's always going to display. So like the hero, if you want this to be hidden, you would just click hide there. So let's just do it. Okay, and it goes away. Now let's bring it back. The header, however, you have to click in here and then change the desktop layout. So here you have the option to hide your header or not hide it. So we're not going to hide it right now because we want to update it. And just remember, whatever you do with desktop, you want to make sure you do with mobile as well. And the footer, yeah, the footer is hidden by default. So we'll want to show that too, both under desktop and mobile. Let's unhide those. Okay, because these are the things that we're actually customizing right now on our template landing page. Okay, so we'll go into header. And when the page was created, it defaulted to having these blocks. So logo, and it pulled this from my site details. It's something that we already installed when we were doing settings. However, it's super tiny right here. So I'm going to change that by changing the logo image width. Actually, I think I want it 300. Okay. So you've updated your logo. And now they, for some reason, it always has two menus. Here, it has my main menu and then this about and contact menu. But I'm gonna delete this. You can delete any of these blocks, but the ones that you do want to include, you want to include your logo and then your custom header that you just created in your navigation. So I have this demo header navigation. So within menu, you can open this up and then this dropdown will open up all your navigation menus, both the default ones and your custom ones. And you can check this box to open a new tab so that it keeps this window open and then just opens these in new tabs, which I like that. I prefer that. So you'll notice that also, this user menu was included when I created this landing page. So what that means is you need to provide a way for your members to log in. And you have three different options. One, you can create a color coordinated call to action button in the header. Two, you can use a user menu. Or three, you can set it up as part of the header navigation menu, like the custom navigation menu we created here. So I'm going to show you real quick what those three different options look like. Okay, number one, you can add a call to action. So you'll change the text and then button action is go to a URL. The URL is going to be your domain followed by / login. So, and you have to include HTTPS. So I'm just going to, I just want to make sure I get the whole thing. / login. Oops. Login. Okay. So we'll pop that in there. And yes, I want it to open in a new tab. Okay. So now if we preview this page and I click member login, it's going to open up this login screen. And this will appear the same no matter if it's a member who's logged in or not. Or a non-member. It's going to appear the same to everyone. So that's your first option, a color coordinated CTA button. Option two is to include a user menu. So I'm going to delete this one and add content. I'm going to add a user menu. So we'll save this. What that means is that if it is somebody who's logged in, if it's a member who's logged in, they're going to see this little avatar thing here. Let's refresh this. Okay, so because I'm logged in as an admin and I can go to my library settings or log out. If somebody who is not a member or a member who's not logged in goes to this landing page, I'll show you what it looks like. I'm going to copy the URL and open up an incognito window so it doesn't know that I'm an admin. And it takes me to the same page, but now instead of seeing my little avatar image up here, it has login. So, and then it takes me to the login screen where you log in. So that's your second option is including a user menu in your header. And your third option is to include it as part of the header navigation menu itself. So in that case, we would delete this one. So I'm going to go to my main menu, add link, member login, save. Okay, so now what does it look like if I refresh? So that went away, and now we have member login, and that's going to take me to the login screen. So those are your three options. You have to include something so that your members know how to log in. I like option two. I like the user menu. That one's my favorite. And finally, your footer, the footer for your template landing page. So we're going to go back to your sections and down to footer. There's a logo here, but it's against a black background, so you can't really see it. So link list, this is the same thing as a menu, just for some reason it's called a link list down here. But we're going to select that footer because we know that that has the links to our legal pages. And under copyright, the copyright defaults to Kajabi, so you would change it to your business name, Nazim. And the last thing that you want to include is your social links, social media links, which you can do by social icons here. So, and I definitely like to open a new tab here so that they can remain on this page while they're checking out your social media. And these Kajabi's links are included here by default. So you would need to update those. And you only want to include the platforms that you're active on. Just pick two or three and really focus on those. So that's what your template landing page is going to look like. And one other quick thing is the social icons, which is, it's optional. We're going to add it to the template landing page so that it's always there and you don't have to go find these, your social links. However, if you are using this landing page as either a sales page or like a webinar registration or lead magnet opt-in, something that's not just informational, something that you really want people to take action on, you would delete these social media icons because you don't want to include any sort of exits from the page that you don't have to. So I would hide the, you can hide the header entirely. You have to include the footer, but just delete the social media icons. Just delete this whole block. If it's a sales page, opt-in registration page, something like that.
Okay, so now you've created your template landing page. Anytime you need to create a new landing page in the future, you'll just duplicate this page and then add whatever content you need for the new page. Copy, graphics, call to action buttons, everything. And you'll know that everything is going to be the same on all these pages that you create in the future. So that should save you some time. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.